الحمد لله الذي هدانا لهذا وما كنا لنهتدي لولا أن هدانا الله. الحمد لله الذي خلق فسوى، والذي قدر فهدى، والذي أخرج المرعى فجعله غثاء أحوى. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله وصفيُّه وخليلُه وخيرتُه من خلقِه، صلواتُ ربي وسلامُه عليه وعلى الآل والصحب الكرام. أما بعد، فاتقوا الله عباد الله، واتقوا يومًا تُرجعون فيه إلى الله، ثم تُوفَّى كلُّ نفسٍ ما كسبَت وهم لا يُظلمون. My beloved brothers and sisters, this is the month of Ramadan, and this is a Friday within the month of Ramadan. And this is the time of Salatul Jumu'ah. So we have a blessed moment in a blessed week, in a blessed month. And all this is the favor of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. My advice to you and to myself is to be conscious of Allah, to worship Him alone. For indeed, He is the owner of entire creation, the creator who placed you and I on earth without us having a say. None of us is on earth because we chose to be here, but rather we are on earth because we were placed here. And therefore develop a relationship with the one who has made you. He alone deserves to be worshipped. When a person enters the fold of Islam, they declare what we know as the Shahada. In it, they bear witness that there is none worthy of worship besides Allah. Why then would we be worshipping any deity or anyone or anything besides Allah? So it's very important to seize a beautiful month like the month of Ramadan to connect with the Maker alone. It is also the month of solidarity. Today we are seated here in our thousands, wanting to hear something that will bring us closer to Allah and His Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Because it's the month of Ramadan, our hearts are softened. But do you realize it's the month of solidarity? Those who are seated here with you are your brothers, your sisters in faith, which is a stronger relation than the relation of blood. If you feel a good feeling towards those whom you come across as you do your daily chores and go to work and come back, those whom you meet, those whom you see, if you feel a connection, and if you feel that if they were in trouble in any way, shape or form, you would try your best to assist them as per your capacity, then inshallah you are heading in the right direction. The month of Ramadan is a month of reaching out to those in need, not just in need of money, not just in need of food and drink, in need of anything, at times even a good word. May Allah Almighty make us from among those who are conscious of this. If that is the case, and it is, then imagine saying a bad word. Imagine uttering that which is abusive, hurtful, hateful. Surely it would be the opposite of what is required of you as a believer. And therefore, remember the statement of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, where he says, a believer is not abusive. He is not deceitful. He is not hurtful. He is not vulgar. But rather, a believer is he who utters that which is upright. مَنْ كَانَ يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ فَلْيَقُلْ خَيْرًا أَوْ لِيَصْمُتْ. Whoever believes in Allah and in the last day, meaning a person who is truly concerned about the account that is going to be taken on the day of judgment, such a person would only utter that which is beneficial or remain silent. May Allah Almighty grant us the ability to use our tongues and our mouths in His remembrance and in that which will be beneficial for us on the Day of Judgment. This is a month of the Quran because the Quran was revealed in this beautiful month of Ramadan. شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس. Allah says it is the month of Ramadan in which the Quran was revealed as a guidance to mankind. I promise you, my brothers and sisters, the most powerful word in existence is the word of Allah. The most powerful message there is in existence is the message sent to you by Allah. Do you know that message? When Allah has specialized a month every single year of your life that is known as the month of the Quran, but you have not done enough to understand the message of Allah that is the most powerful, most important message. Surely a day like this should be a day of contemplating, considering, and thinking about how we can do better when it comes to understanding the word of Allah. There are people who have reached their 50s and 60s and they've read so many books in their lives during their school days and perhaps later on, but at times they are guilty of not even trying to read the Quran and understand it. Our duty towards the Quran is not only to perfect the Arabic recitation. Yes, that is extremely important. And yes, you will get a reward for every letter multiplied by 10, and in Ramadan, even beyond that. But you will get an equal reward for learning, trying to understand, putting into practice, and conveying it to others. أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. In more than one place in the Quran, Allah is asking a question. Will you not consider, contemplate, ponder deeply over the verses of the Quran? Are you not going to attempt to try and understand it, to try and ponder over it, to look into it? Well, that is the message. At a loss is the one who spends his life without knowing what did Allah actually tell me in His book. The message was for me. This is why we have the month of Ramadan that keeps coming again and again. We are fortunate in our beautiful masajid. May Allah reward those who made this masjid and who actually thought of putting it here. And may Allah reward all those who have put up masajid across the globe. And may He use us to put up these masajid, to make use of them. We are so fortunate we have these houses of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where melodious recital during the month of Ramadan in many of those masajid, the entire Quran is completed in recitation. How beautiful is that? Imagine the reward of the people who read, the reward of those who listen. But do you realize there is an equal reward for the one who attempts to understand that word? I cannot overemphasize the issue of connecting with the meaning of the Quran. It will change your life. Promise today that we will spend a portion of the day, even if it be 5 minutes a day, to try and connect with the Quran in the most beautiful way. This is the month of the Quran. That is why we are speaking about it specifically. May Allah Almighty accept it from us. My brothers and sisters, the Quran will transform you. It will develop your character and conduct. When Aisha radiallahu anha was asked about the character and conduct of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam, she answered with a simple sentence, "Kana khuluquhu al-Qur'an." His character was the Quran. From this, it means that the Quran would transform you and I to the degree where your character and conduct would outshine everybody else. May Allah make us from among those with the best of character and conduct. Yet in the same Quran, Allah speaks about Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, and Allah Almighty says, وَإِنَّكَ لَعَلَى خُلُقٍ عَظِيمٍ. Indeed, you are upon the highest level of character and conduct, if we can translate it that way. Azim, huge, something massive. The most impressive character and conduct was that of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. It's not easy to be kind to those who are unkind, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did it. It's not easy to be good to those who have harmed you, but the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam did it. Subhanallah. He was on another level. May Allah Almighty grant us the ability to study his life and to put into practice aspects of his life to the best of our ability. Wallahi, my brothers, my sisters, the fact that we are seated here so content, so peaceful, fasting for the sake of Allah. One pillar of Islam is fasting. Another pillar that we're about to engage in is the prayer, subhanallah. Another pillar that we will engage in the month of Ramadan, those who have the wealth, to give that wealth. It's not necessary to give your zakah in Ramadan, but it is rewarding of a higher degree if you do that. May Allah Almighty grant us success upon success. So the gift of Allah, when you notice the contentment you have in your heart, it's a gift. That contentment will only come when you connect with Allah. Whatever happens in your life is from Allah. Do not despair. You have a month of Ramadan, a month where your problems become small because the problems of others are great. Look at our brothers and sisters struggling in Gaza, in Palestine. It would be wrong for us not to mention them and pray for them. When we hear and see what goes on and is going on there, automatically our problems become minute, small. It's like we don't even have a problem. May Allah Almighty help us all in our own difficulties and issues. And may Allah Almighty help and guard and guide our brothers and sisters in Palestine. My beloved brothers and sisters, the month of the Quran is a month wherein which all of us should be reminding each other to do good. The fact that you asked someone or reminded them to do good, you get a full reward of the good that they do. So why not? This is why Allah Almighty says people are at a loss. Innal insana lafi khusr. Allah swears by the token of time, and he says, indeed, man is at a loss. Besides those who do what? Remind each other. Besides those who remind each other, إِلَّا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالْحَقِّ وَتَوَاصَوْا بِالصَّبْرِ. Man is at a loss except those who believe and do good deeds and remind each other about the truth and about justice, and remind each other to bear patience. My brothers and sisters, Allah has promised all of us. Allah has promised all of us that He will test us. That's why we're on earth. In fact, every single one of us has challenges. The richest and the poorest, the healthiest and the one who is unwell. May Allah grant cure to those who are unwell. Those who are the most good looking and those whom community might not consider as good looking. Everyone has some issues, no matter who you are. That itself is evidence and proof that Allah made you to test you. This morning I had a message from a young man asking me if he could have permanent tattoos and why couldn't he have those tattoos. And I told him, if someone were to give you a motor vehicle of theirs and tell you that I want this vehicle back at a certain time, do you have the right to scratch or to inscribe your name or anything you think on someone else's vehicle? No. The body you have is given to you by Allah only for a short time while you are being tested. When you enter a hard hat zone where there is construction happening and they want to take you to show you the place, they will give you a helmet and they might give you some protective clothing. When you enter, you wear it. When you exit, you remove it and say, thank you very much. Here is the clothing. If something fell, a stone or two or a rock or two, you were saved because of your helmet, and you were intelligent enough not to break the helmet and do silly things to it, because if that was the case, you probably would have injured yourself and you would be to blame. So in the same way, when we entering this earth, Allah puts the soul into a body, and Allah says, I'm going to separate the soul from the body once the mission is accomplished. What is the mission? I'm putting you onto earth and I'd like you to do as much good as you can until I decide that now your mission is accomplished. Come back to us. Let's see what you've done. That's exactly what Allah has done. So I cannot decide to do something to this body that is not ordained by the one who actually owns the body. This is why, my brothers and sisters, the point I am making is we will be tested by Allah. He's put us into a body. The soul goes in, and He allowed us entry into the world for a short time. He will test us with 1, 2, 3, 20, 30, 40, 200, 300, 400 tests. Some of them will be massive, some of them will be small. He promises you, when I love you, I'm going to test you more. I just want to see. I told you I'm going to test you. What are you going to do? You lost your job. Do you come closer to me? You lost your health. Do you come closer to me? You lost something else. Do you come closer to me? You lost a loved one. Do you come closer to me? Or do you turn away and forget that you yourself are going to come back to us? May Allah Almighty make us conscious of this. So this is why the contentment is definitely evident upon the faces of the believers who are connected with Allah, and they understand that this world is temporary. We are going to be tested, and it's okay. I will rise to the challenge by the help of Allah. So this is the month of solidarity, as I said, the month of reaching out to those in need, reaching out to those who are struggling and suffering in any way, shape or form. May Allah Almighty use us to do good. We have the fasting that I'm not going to go into, because every one of us knows that we stay away from certain things in Ramadan. But I want to tell you very importantly, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam warns those who stay away from food and drink, but do not stay away from bad mouthing and foul language and deception and false witness. He says, مَنْ لَمْ يَدَعْ قَوْلَ الزُّورِ وَالْعَمَلَ بِهِ وَالْجَهْلَ فَلَيْسَ لِلَّهِ حَاجَةٌ فِي أَنْ يَدَعَ طَعَامَهُ وَشَرَابَهُ. Whoever is not going to quit or leave false witness and uttering that which is bad, that which is deceptive, that which is abusive and so on during the month of Ramadan, then Allah does not have a need for that person to have quit food and drink. In other words, they wasted their time fasting. May Allah Almighty help us develop the best of habits in the month of Ramadan. May Allah Almighty help us to become the best of people. May we not only quit our sins for Ramadan, but even post Ramadan. May we not only become people conscious of what we say during Ramadan, but even outside of Ramadan. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'ani wa sunnati wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima feehima min al ayati wal hikmati aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullaha li wa lakum wa lisairil muslimin fastaghfiruhu innahu huwal ghafurur rahim.